currently in a place where there's a lot of politics and a lot of news, but there's also people out there that are turning their taps on and not willing to drink the water. So right now, the city of Flint has a much smaller staff than they had many years ago. At the city level, they don't have really any resources of folks who are professional data scientists that can look at data in aggregate, apply newer algorithms that are being developed by researchers in my area and in other areas. So we are hoping to provide some of our expertise to their needs.
The test is only as good as the water that's in there. The water is only as good as the brain.
What we have right now for every property in Flint, for every parcel of land, we have information about the parcel that can be used for a predictive algorithm to decide, oh, is this a property that should be at risk? Those properties are likely to have a very high level of lead in their water. So one thing that we've suggested them so far, and one thing we've been able to develop, is a set of predictions. And that provides advice to folks on the public health side and from the city side, where they might want to check further for lead pipes, lead service lines, where they might want to check for lead in the plumbing, and where they might want to just be concerned more broadly about the local infrastructure of those regions. Our long-term goals are really to just provide as much value to the citizens and the city and state officials. This is not just a fun little visualization challenge. There are humans that are actually dealing with this on a daily basis, and those folks need support.